the GIMPs have been at it again. They found a new prime number, the largest prime number that's been found to date. The GIMPs, of course, are the great internet Mersenne prime search team. A network of computers and people that work on these computers that look for large Mersenne primes. It's a pretty big number, to the power, now I've got to remember this now, 57,885,161 - 1. So the 57,885,161 is a prime number, but this bad boy, the whole thing, is also a prime number. Of course, it's a much bigger one, and that is the largest prime number ever to be found. It's the 48th Mersenne prime ever to be found as well.
Can you remind us what a Mersenne prime is?
Yeah, so essentially, the Mersenne prime, you just take 2, you take it to some power p, and this is a prime number, minus 1, and that's your Mersenne prime. It's pretty interesting how they've gone about finding this as well. I mean, there's various things about it. I mean, for example, the way it's done is they have this GIMPS network, have this, you know, they're a network of shared computers, and they use their combined computing power to basically work out, try and find these prime numbers. So it's quite an interesting that there's this sort of collaboration going on to find these things. From my point of view, it's actually reminiscent of something that they do at the LHC to manage the data. They use a network of computers around the world to analyze that data. So it's not always academics that are finding these things, and anybody can get involved in the project. And there's, you know, there's money on the table as well when it comes to finding these things. Curtis Cooper will win, looks like $3,000 for finding this number. It's a bit of a shame for him because this number actually has, it has this many digits. It's this many digits long. It is 17,425,170 digits long, I think. The reason this is a little bit annoying for Curtis Cooper is that it's not 100 million digits long. Because if it had been 100 million digits long, then he would have won $150,000. Because that's the prize on offer if you can find one for that's actually that long. It's worth thinking about how big this number actually is. We've talked about big numbers in the past, Brady. It is bigger than a Google. It's not as big as a Googleplex. It's certainly not as big as Graham's number. You could easily think of this number without your head collapsing to form a black hole. There's no problem there. In fact, actually, it's quite easy to think of. You could even memorize this number. Here we have the number. So this is the number written out in full. It's quite a big file. There you go. It's got 17.5 million digits. This file is about 22 meg. Now, apparently, your brain can store about 2.5 million gig of memory. So technically, you could memorize this number without having a problem. And in fact, I'm going to be cocky here because I actually can write this. I'm going to write this number. I've remembered this number, but I've remembered it in base 2. Okay, so let me write it out in base 2. I was quite impressed that I remembered this. So the first number is 1. The second number, it's also 1. And the next one's also 1. And the next one is also 1. And I would carry on writing 1s until I got all the way to the last number, which is also 1, and there would be a grand total of 557,885,161 of these 1s, and that is the number written in base 2. So I can prove that for you if you want that.
Go on.
Okay, so the reason that that's why it is in base 2. Okay, so what is it? Let's look at this number. Let's just call it P for now, rather than this 57 million, because we can prove this in generality. I can actually factorize this expression. And I can factorize this expression as follows. It's 2 minus 1, okay, that's obviously 1, multiplied by 1 plus 2 squared, all the way up to 2p minus 1. Okay, so this is obviously 1 out front. So what I'm left with is just all the, basically, the essential units of base 2 with 1s in front. That's it. So that's the proof. So there's obviously p of these. So in total, so this is, in our case, p is 57,885,161. And so this is how you would write it out in base 2.
In base 10, which is what more people are familiar with, what's the first and last digit?
So I'm going to have to look this one up. Well, I think I know the first, actually. It's 5, isn't it? It's 5. And the last one, can I look?
Yeah.
I've got a feeling the last one's... Well, we know it's going to be an odd number, don't we? So let's go up. 1. There you go. Of course, we have a new perfect number, okay, from this. And it's very easy to write down what it is. And the perfect number that we have, 2, to the 57,885,160 multiplied by 2 to the 57,885,161 minus 1. That's our new perfect number. It's about 34 million digits long. Yep, that's our new perfect number we've got out of this. So, woo! So it's all good fun, basically, isn't it? And I think, but there is an important point to come from these searches. I mean, they're fun to look at. It's nice, you know, it's interesting. Oh, we found this new big prime number. There's a lot of technology that goes into sort of developing the software to do these calculations because, you know, basically, if you actually tried to calculate all the divisors of this guy, if you used all the numbers that are smaller than it and tried to, you know, see if they were factors of that number, you know, if you did that, you know, just like that, you know, sort of blindly, you know, you'd find that you'd need more than the age of the universe to actually do that calculation. So there's sophisticated techniques at work here. And all this game and all this developing this computing power, you know, in particular ways to multiply large numbers, really have had, you know, sort of impact elsewhere, for example. You know, so it's the spin-off technologies that are coming from the sort of, you know, really mathematicians playing games. But, you know, you should never knock mathematicians playing games because they can, you know, the crumbs that fall off the table can be of benefit to everybody else.
If you'd like to see even more from this interview, including a rather strange discussion about my family tree, I've got an unlisted video with all the offcuts and extra footage. I basically didn't put it as a listed video because I didn't want to clog up everyone's subscription boxes. And if you want to find out more about some of these topics and you haven't watched our back catalogue of videos, I've also put links to our films about Mersenne primes, perfect numbers, Googles and Googleplexes, Graham's number, all that kind of stuff. Check out the links under the video or here on the screen.